tonight for chapel. Okay, most of you guys, all of us remember him. Okay, he's a great friend of the program, personal friend. As you guys know, I'm not huge on the introductions. He'll let you guys know he's here real quick. Put your hands together. Spencer Conley. Welcome to Texas, man. And just as last time, I am humbled to have the opportunity to stand before you and to speak encouragement to your life. Coach Kill, I thank you and your staff. I don't take it lightly. I understand the job that you men have in helping these young men on their way. I do not take it lightly. And I truly appreciate the opportunity to stand before you men. Real quick. You know, we get used to, you know, when you get used to things, when you get used to the thing, after a while, it just, you know, it just becomes something that you always say. Like God is good.
All the time. God is good.
Exactly. You just get used to saying. So I'm going to build this message off of something that you guys, you have on your shirt, that you're used to saying all the time. Brick by brick. Let me think of brick by brick. You know, and we get used to saying things and you see it. You know, I want to make sure that doesn't lose its luster, because you are going to live off of it for the rest of your life. For the rest of your life. How many of you guys, by the show of hands, know what Philippians 4:13 says? By the show of hands. I'm good, thankful. Now, most of you guys have heard it. You didn't know by the show of hands. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Now, how many of you have heard that before? You heard that, okay. Now how many of you guys believe that? How many of you guys, okay, you know, some of them still not sure, we question it. No, no, I understand. And it's easy to question it, because I have found that man knows more than he understands. And in 15 minutes, before I'm done, we're going to understand what brick by brick is. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. When I first started teaching this, most people would say, hey, they believe that, Coach. You know, I believe that because it's in the Bible. Now, Paul wrote the majority of the New Testament. He didn't have the opportunity to say, I believe it because it was in the Bible, because it's not enough. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. How do you know that? How do you know that? Well, very simple. People put this on their business card. They hang it in their office because it sounds powerful. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. It sounds powerful. It sounds good. And it sounds like I'm protected. It sounds like my back is got. It sounds like I'm covered. And it sounds like something good when I say it. And it sounds intimidating. But again, because man knows more than he understands, he doesn't understand how to work it and how to use it properly. And I'm going to help you. Are you ready? Before 13, 11, and 12 says this. Paul is talking, he says, I've been content. Everybody say content.
Content.
I've learned to be content. Everybody say, I've learned.
I've learned.
You have to be happy. You have to be excited about where you are in life, because it could be worse. Before tons of people that wish that they were sitting right where you are, that they had fresh water, that they had a great opportunity to be properly educated. They wish they had those opportunities. So it's not that easy. Paul said, I have learned to be content. I've been abased and I've been abound. I've been hungry, Coach, and I've been full. Because of all that, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. He had been to a place. It wasn't just something that you put on a card. It was, hey, that is a testimony. That's something that you lived. Hey, when I was hungry, there was God. When I was full, there was God. When I was high, there was God. When I was low, he was still there. And because I built that relationship and I have it with him and I've seen him through all that, I know it's assurance, men, that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Back to what matters to you. Somebody say brick by brick.
Brick by brick.
Say it like you mean it. Brick by brick.
Brick by brick.
It's not just your idea. You have to add something to it. You have to add something to it. Think of brick by brick, one at a time. Hey, Paul said one at a time. I was hungry, then I was full. I was a base, then I was a bound. Brick by brick, he got better at every area of his walk in life. He got better at every area of being a man. And because of that, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. It's because of that. It's because of what comes before. It's because of the work that you put in. That's why you expect victory. Because of what you've done before you line up. That's why you expect it. No other reason. That's simple. But I can do all things through Christ, brick by brick. Now which one, Jeff? Which brick? All of them, man. Because the brick that you use for football is not the same that you're going to have to use to be a father. The weight of that brick has left 15 million kids without a dad. 15 million homes without a father in America. Because that brick is heavy, and the pressure from that weight causes some people to become cowards. And some of you know what I'm talking about. All of them, men, it has to be worth it to you. When you're building something great, you can't pick and choose what brick you use. You have to get closer. And you need people around you that love you, to help you continue to build every aspect of your life, brick by brick. Every aspect, every brick. Just trust me. You ask these men. It's cool for a while. And you'll get excited. And you'll spend all kinds of money that you wish you didn't. And you'll get married. But you ask them about the pressure of being a husband, being responsible for somebody. It's not as easy as lining up, playing ball. You have to continue to build the man, the most precious and priceless part of your being. Because you know, you're still building, but you're building a wall around yourself. And you're not getting anywhere. It has to be with purpose and direction. Brick by brick. All of them. Man, is it worth it? 2 million, 2.3 million stones weighing over 2.5 tons a piece to build the Great Pyramids. Is it worth it to you? Or would you stand before that mountain and say, no, another day? Well, I want to do something different. Because slaves didn't build those pyramids, men. We were told that, but they weren't slaves. There were people who were committed to the exercise because they believed in their land. They believed in their purpose. They believed in Minnesota football. They believed in the University of Minnesota. They believed in that community. And they found that this is worth living and dying. And I don't know any other way but to do it hard and to invest everything I have in. Men, you have to buy in. And you have to keep doing it. This game is no different than any other. Your focus, again, as I said a long time ago, is on you. It's about execution. There's no way you can lose if you execute better than your opponent. And how do you do that? It's not just about having wisdom. It's about understanding the things that you know. About what you're being taught by your coaches, by your professors, and how you're learning about who you are through one another. Again, men, prepare yourself. Coaches as well, it's easy. to grow up a little bit and look back and get complacent. Coaches as well, everybody in here, we all, even myself included, we all have to be prepared to give up who you are for who you may become at any time. God bless you. I know you're hungry. Let's eat.